Hello friends, welcome to Affairs Cloud, we learn to lead. My name is Vikas and in today's video, we'll be looking at the most important current affairs of the April month. The session will be very helpful to you, so do watch the video till the end. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, do subscribe, hit the like button and share the link with your friends. So let's start with our video, but before that, we have something important to tell you about. We have an app by the name Careers Cloud, which you can go and download through the Play Store. Once you have downloaded the app, you will open the app and you will see this type of screen. In this, you can go and log in with your Google account, that is your Gmail ID. Then once you have logged in, then you will be moved to this page where you can see a window. If you click on the current affairs section here, then you will be moved to this page. Now this is where magic happens. This is the course where there are two courses provided by us. First, you should know it is of 1 year and 2 years. So choose your course accordingly. What we are providing and what is the reason behind that you should purchase course of current affairs from us and what are the important details about it. First thing you should know that we provide you current affairs in both English and Hindi. Okay. Also, we provide you here current affairs daily. PDFs are provided daily. The important factor here to remember is we are providing PDF to you daily. Okay, that contains question answers of the daily current affairs. They are explained in a much easy way where you can grasp the knowledge and do your revision. Okay, apart from that, we provide you with question answers. Then on every day we provide you 20 question answers quiz, daily 20 questions quiz. So imagine how much it will benefit you in your preparation. Then we provide you same thing for weekly. In weekly we take a quiz of 50 questions. Then question answers of week, we provide you a book, a PDF is provided you weekly of the compiled questions of the whole week. Similarly for monthly also, ebook is given, your quizzes are taken, question answers PDF. Then apart from it, we also help you to prepare for banking papers. All the banking exams you can go refer to our videos and our courses here. You can see here that we provide you banking and economic quiz of 157 questions. Okay, then topic wise PDFs are covered. As you can see, we are making videos on indexes and reports, important days, the books and authors, all the events that are taking place in individual months. So these PDFs are provided to you and they will help you a lot in your preparation for journal awareness, your journal studies, as well as for current affairs. Then you can see we also provide you current affairs for state wise current affairs are provided to you. Apart from this, I have a gift for all of my friends here. If you use my code VIKAS10, you will be getting a straight 10% discount on the purchase you make. So when you are about to check out and do the payment, just before the payment, you will be getting an option to use the promo code. There you can put the VIKAS10, the code, and you will be getting an extra 10% discount on the total purchase you make there. So let's start with our video. So friends, let's start with the first question. Which organization released the report by the name Investment Opportunities in India's Healthcare Sector that predicts investments in healthcare sector to reach USD 372 billion by 2022? Important point to remember about this question is that the investment in health sector will reach $372 billion by 2022. All right, and this report or this statement has been made by whom, the question is asking that. This statement comes under Investment Opportunities in India's Healthcare Sector report, and this report was released by Niti Aayog. All right, Niti Aayog. Remember, the investment is growing at the rate of 22%, and that too at compound annual growth rate of 22% since 2016. Alright, so this question here is who released this particular report? It was released by Niti Aayog. Next question. Where was the joint military exercise Vajra Prahar 2021 conducted between India and USA Special Forces? Joint military exercise by the name Vajra Prahar. वज्र प्रहार इज अ मिलिट्री एक्सरसाइज बिटवीन इंडिया एंड हुम यूएसए. ऑल राइट, इट इज एन एक्सरसाइज बिटवीन इंडिया एंड यूएसए. अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट रिमेंबर एक्सरसाइज सच एज युद्ध अभ्यास एंड टाइगर ट्रम्प. These all the three exercises are conducted between India and USA. Now the question is, Vajra Prahar 2021 was conducted between India and USA. And the question is, where in which state of India it was conducted? It was conducted in Himachal Pradesh. Then next thing is, if I ask you about where was PESEX conducted, PESEX exercise was conducted in Bay of Bengal. Options will be Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea, Indian Ocean, Pacific Ocean. The correct answer will be Bay of Bengal. Then if I ask you about exercise between India and Bangladesh, the name is Sampriti. Then if I ask you about exercise between India and France, the name, there are three exercises: Garuda, Shakti and Varuna. They are between India and France. Next question. Which organization is setting up two undersea cables by the name ECO and Bifrost? See, ECO and Bifrost. First of all, these are the two names that you should know. ECO and Bifrost are the two undersea cables that will be connecting Indonesia with USA. Means this is a connection between USA and Indonesia. What is the purpose of these cables? It is to provide internet connection. Alright, it is to provide internet connection. The question here is, which company is setting up these two undersea cables, ECO and Bifrost, that will be connecting Indonesia with USA to provide internet? The name of the company is Facebook. Alright, the name of the company is Facebook. Next question. Who received the Saraswati Samman 2020 award for his novel Sanatan? Two questions comes here. That's first of all, Saraswati Samman is given in the field of literature. Alright, then. Wait, Saraswati Samman. This big award is given in the field of literature. Alright. Who gives this award? This is given. This is also important. And it has been asked earlier in the papers that who gives the Saraswati Samman award? It is given by K.K. Birla Foundation. Alright. And next thing is that recently in 2020, who is the person that received the Saraswati Samman Award for his novel Sanatan? And the name of the person is Sharan Kumar Limbaleji. Alright, remember this was the 30th edition. This was the 30th edition of this Saraswati Samman Award in 2020. Alright, so moving on to the next. Next question is, which country topped the medal tally in 2021 ISSF Shooting World Cup? Alright, ISSF Shooting World Cup. This was held in New Delhi. Who won the maximum medals in this World Cup? The country that won the maximum number of medals in this World Cup was India, with 30 medals. Alright, with 30 medals. And that too, from 30 medals, 15 were gold, 9 were silver, and 6 were bronze. On second position, this was first, on second position was USA with a total of 8 medals. And on third position was your Italy with a total of 4 medals. Alright, so the correct answer is option 3. India topped the medal tally in 2021 ISSF Shooting World Cup that was held in New Delhi. Alright, next. Who won the gold medal in the 2021 ISSF World Cup in the women's 25 meter pistol event? C. Gold medal. In women's category and in that too, the 25 meter pistol event. And the person that won the gold medal in the women's category in 25 meter pistol event is Chinky Yadav. Alright, the person is Chinky Yadav. Next. Where is the annual Purvanchal Festival Mati celebrated? Mati is a festival that we started celebrating recently only since 2018, and this festival is celebrated in Delhi NCR. Also remember, if we are talking about Purvanchal, then the other name of Purvanchal or Purvanchal is also known by the name the Land of Warriors. The Land of Warriors. All right, next. Where was the first World Immunization and Logistics Summit 2021 conducted, which saw the virtual participation of the Health Minister Harshvardhan? I repeat, where was the first World Immunization and Logistics Summit 2021 conducted, which saw the virtual participation of our Health Minister Harshvardhan ji? So where was the first Immunization and Logistics Summit conducted? It was conducted at Abu Dhabi, UAE. Alright, Abu Dhabi, UAE. Next. Who was appointed as the chairman and the managing director of Oil and Natural Gas Corporation in April? Who became the new chairman and MD of ONGC? Who is the person? The name of the person is Subhash Kumar. Subhash Kumar is the new chairman and the managing director of Oil and National Gas Corporation. Next question. Next question is very important. Mark this question important. Alright. See. FIFA announced 9 host cities and 10 stadiums for 2023's Women's Football World Cup. Question. First question. Women's Football World Cup will be held when? It will be held in 2023. First question. Second question that is being asked here. Which countries are jointly hosting this event? Hosting the Women's Football World Cup 2023. So the two countries that are jointly hosting it are Australia and New Zealand. Australia and New Zealand will be jointly hosting the 2023's Women's Football World Cup. Next question. Who is the only Indian women discus thrower? I repeat, who is the only Indian women's discus thrower to qualify for the 2020 Tokyo Olympic Games? Who is the only women? So I told you, if there is the first question, first women of that particular organization or in that particular field, or the only women to do a particular task, such questions are important and have higher chance of being asked in the question. So, the only women or the only Indian women discus thrower to qualify for the 2020 Tokyo Olympic Games is Kamalpreet Kaur. Alright, Kamalpreet Kaur was the only Indian woman who has qualified for the women's discus throw event. Next, which is the first state in India to commission farm-based solar power projects under PM Kusum scheme? First state. Under PM Kusum scheme. PM Kusum scheme is basically to help the farmers earn more by providing the solar power to them, and so that they can also put up their solar power plant there in their field and earn a little extra cash, as they can get free solar energy and they can also get the free electricity to charge their pumps they are using or the tractors they will be using if they are electric. Alright, so which is the first state in India to commission the farm-based solar power projects? The first state that will commission the farm-based solar power project is your Rajasthan. All right, this question is important. Anything related to renewable energy or anything related to environment automatically becomes important. All right, so do take a note of it that the Rajasthan became the first state in India to commission the farm-based solar power projects, and that too under PM Kusum scheme. In April 2021, which organization approved a loan worth of $32 million for which state for improving the management capacity and quality of health sector services? So, to improve the health sector of which state, which organization provided with a loan of $32 million to that state? So, the answer is, first thing, the state was Mizoram and the organization was World Bank. All right, one by one. World Bank approved a loan worth of $32 million to Mizoram state for improving the health sector of that particular state. So the correct option becomes option one, World Bank and Mizoram. All right. If we talk about World Bank, the president of World Bank is David Malpass and headquarters is in Washington, D.C. And the headquarters in Washington, D.C. So World Bank and IMF, they both have their headquarters in Washington, D.C. Next. Who was awarded with the Kalinga Ratna Samman for the year 2021 for his contribution to Odia literature? In contribution to Odia literature, who is the person that has been honored with the Kalinga Ratna Samman for the year 2021? And the person who has been honored with this award is Biswa Bhushan Harichandan ji. Biswa Bhushan Harichandan ji was honored with Kalinga Ratna Samman for his contribution to Odia literature. Then the award is given by whom? Kalinga Ratna Samman is given by whom? This award is given by Sarla Sahitya Sansad, and this award is being given since 2007. All right, given since 2007. Next question. Next question is also important. A new flowering species was recently discovered in the Western Ghats of Maharashtra. Where it was discovered? This question can also be asked. Western Ghats, or you can say option can be Maharashtra. Here a new flowering species was discovered by the name Argyria, and this Argyria Sharad Chandra ji. This flowering species was named after whom? This flowering species was named after a reputed person by the name Sharad Pawar. Alright, Sharad Pawar. You mark this question important. It can be asked. Alright, next. What was the growth rate projected for India in the fiscal year as per the International Monetary Fund's World Economic Outlook report? See, who releases World Economic Outlook report? Who releases the World Economic Outlook report? This is released by IMF. Where is the headquarter of IMF? It is in Washington, D.C. So what is the projected report as per the IMF's World Economic Outlook report? The projected growth for India was expected to be 12.5% by IMF. And IMF, if we are talking about, it was established in 1944, headquarters is in Washington, D.C. And if we ask about the managing director of International Monetary Fund is Kristalina Georgieva. All right, Kristalina Georgieva. All right, moving to next. President of India appointed whom as the new Chief Justice of India? First, tell me this. N.V. Ramana ji has been appointed as the new Chief Justice of India by President. So, question can also be framed in such a manner that who appoints the Chief Justice of India? Chief Justice of India is appointed by our beloved President. And remember, this is N.V. Ramana ji is our 48th president, 48th Chief Justice of India this year. All right, I repeat, he is the 48th Chief Justice of India, N.V. Ramanaji. So, correct option becomes the fifth option, 48th N.V. Ramana. All right, next. This question also becomes important that I just told you that who appoints the Chief Justice of India. So the correct answer is President. Mark this question also. Do take a note that who appoints the Chief Justice of India? He is appointed by President. Next. Which country developed the Poseidon 2M39 torpedo, which is capable of producing radioactive tsunami? Poseidon 2M39. It is a type of a torpedo that is capable of producing radioactive tsunami. The question asked here is, who developed this Poseidon 2M39? It was produced by or developed by Russia. All right, next. Who authored the book Exam Warriors? Most important question. Exam Warriors was the book that was authored by our PM Narendra Modi ji. All right, Exam Warrior, much very important question this is. Next, what is the theme of the 2021's World Health Day, which is annually celebrated by the UN on the 7th of April? World Health Day. First of all, tell me, when is the World Health Day celebrated? It is celebrated on 7th of April. Also tell me, if I ask you about World Earth Day, when it is celebrated, or Earth Day, it is celebrated on 22nd of April. All right, Earth Day is celebrated on 27th of April. Then, what was the theme of the World Health Day that was annually observed by the UN on the 7th of April? Theme of this World Health Day. The theme was building a fairer, healthier world. I repeat, building a fairer, healthier world. Next. Next question is, which ministry collaborated with Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation to set up a health cells under the Annamaya initiative to provide health and nutrition support to the tribal people? Remember, Annamaya initiative was to provide good health and nutrition support to tribal people. All right, and if the tribal comes here, then Annamaya was, this initiative was supported by Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation along with MOTA. MOTA is your Ministry of Tribal Affairs. So MOTA and Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, they both together are working for the health and nutrition, to the providing health and nutrition, a better health support and nutrition to the tribal people. All right, next. The option correct, that is fourth, Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Next question. Which country virtually hosted 2021's first meeting of BRICS finance minister and central bank governors? BRICS. Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. All right, these are the five countries, the part of BRICS. The thing you should know about BRICS is that India will be held, or India has the chairmanship of BRICS for the year 2021. India has the chairmanship for 2021, and India will be hosting the 13th BRICS summit. India will be hosting the 13th BRICS summit. All right. So which country hosted? It was hosted by India. All right. Next. Next question also becomes important, that which was the railway zone in India to achieve the 100% electrification. So it was your West Central Railway Zone. All right, it was your West Central Railway Zone. Next question. Who was appointed as the brand ambassador of Vivo? New brand ambassador of Vivo was your Virat Kohli. All right, cricketer Virat Kohli. Next. 2021's International Romani Day marks the 50th anniversary of the first Romani Congress. When is the International Romani Day observed? International Romani Day, when it is observed? It is observed on 8th of April. International Romani Day. Next. Which country is planning to host the virtual summits Leaders Summit on Climate in April 2021. In this summit, our beloved Prime Minister Modi ji has also been invited. So, this summit by the name Leaders Summit on Climate. Leaders Summit. And this summit is on climate. Which country is hosting this virtual summit? This will be hosted by United States of America. All right, next. In April 2021, First Rand Bank decided to withdraw all its banking services from India. The bank belongs to which country? This bank belonged to South Africa. All right, and it withdrew all its banking services from India. It belongs from South Africa. E-commerce major Dash is planning to set up the Asia's largest fulfillment center at Dash. Asia's largest fulfillment center is supposed to be built at Gurgaon, and the company that will be building it is Flipkart. All right, so Flipkart and not this option, Flipkart and Gurgaon. Option 5 is correct. All right, next question. Who was recently appointed as the first women director general of National Council of Applied Economic Research? First DG, and that too first women DG. I will correct it. First women DG of NCAER. Who was the first women of National Council of Applied Economic Research? Tell me. She is Poonam Gupta. All right. Poonam Gupta became the first women director general of National Council of Applied Economic Research. Next, which organization developed the world's first MEMS based micro sensor by the name Dash for explosive trace detection? For explosive trace detection, IIT Bombay developed the world's first MEMS micro based sensor by the name Nano Sniffer. All right, IIT Bombay, and that was named it a Nano Sniffer. Option 4th is correct. Nano Sniffer was the name of the product that for explosive trace detection, for me you can say directly for explosive detection, and IIT Bombay was the organization that developed this Nano Sniffer. Next, in which region of India did researchers discover the three-banded Ross finch? Three-banded Ross finch is a species of a bird that was recently discovered by researchers in Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh. Three-banded Ross finch. Next. In April 2021, Prince Philip passed away at the age of 99. He was the prince of which country? Prince Philip. Prince Philip is also known by the name C. There can be various names by which this question can be asked. The Prince Philip or the Duke of Edinburgh or husband of Queen Elizabeth II. Husband of Queen Elizabeth II. Anything can be asked from these three, and the answer becomes that Prince Philip passed away at the age of 99. He was the Prince of England. Alright, he was the Prince of England. Next. Which state along with Delhi will host the 4th Khelo India Youth Games 2021, which will be held in multiple cities for the first time? Remember, Khelo India Youth Games of 2021 will be hosted by Delhi along with Haryana. Alright, Delhi and Haryana will be hosting the Khelo India Youth Games for the first time, that multiple cities will be hosting it. And remember, this time, this is the 4th edition of the games. So it can also be asked like 4th edition of Khelo India Youth Games will be hosted by Delhi and Haryana together. So option 2 is correct. Next, in April 2021, Prime Minister Narendra Modi released the Hindi translation of the book Odisha Itihas. Who authored the book? Prime Minister Narendra Modi released the Hindi edition of the Odisha Itihas. A Hindi edition of the Odisha Itihas book was released by PM Narendra Modi. The question is, who authored the book? This book was authored by Dr. Hari Krishna Mehtab. Alright, this book was authored by Dr. Hari Krishna Mehtab. Next. Where was the multilateral military exercise Shantir Orgro Sena 2021 that is a mandated UN counter-terrorism exercise conducted? Shantir Orgro Sena 2021. Shantir Orgro Sena, it is a military exercise that was conducted by, or it was a UN mandated counter-terrorism exercise. It was a counter terrorism exercise. It was a counter terrorism exercise. The question is, where was this held, or where this was held? It was held in Bangladesh. All right, it was held in Bangladesh. Shantir Orgro Sena 2021. It is a UN mandated counter terrorism exercise. Next. Which is the first country in the world to introduce a climate change law for regulating the financial sector? So, which is the first country in the world to introduce the climate laws for regulating the financial sector? It is New Zealand. Option 2 is correct. Next. What was the India's GDP projected by Nomura? All right. India's GDP projected by Nomura, it is a Tokyo based or Tokyo Japan based company that projected the growth rate or the GDP of India for the fiscal year 2022 is 12.6%. All right, this is the GDP projection for the fiscal year 22. Next, which country constructed a 5G signal base at the world's highest radar station, Ganbala radar station? Another question can be framed like, which is the highest radar station? Which is the highest radar station? It is your Ganbala radar station. So, which country constructed this 5G signal base at the highest radar station, that is the Ganbala radar station? It was your China. China constructed this highest 5G signal base. All right, next. Which organization recently launched the second version of India Energy Dashboard? Second version of India Energy Dashboard was recently released by Niti Aayog. Next. When was the World's Parkinson's Day annually celebrated? World's Parkinson's Day is annually celebrated on 11th of April. All right, next. Next question. On 9th April, the ICCR, that is your Indian Council for Cultural Relations, celebrated its DAS Foundation Day. Means on 9th of April, we see the Foundation Day of your ICCR, that is Indian Council for Cultural Relations. So this time on in 2021, 9th April, the 71st Foundation Day was celebrated by ICCR. Next question. Dash founded the Indian Council Cultural Relation in Dash. Who founded ICCR? ICCR was founded by Maulana Abdul Kalam Azad and it was founded in 1950. Alright, it was founded in 1950. Next question. In a move to increase farmers' income, Dash signed an MOU with the Agriculture Ministry for implementing its pilot program in 100 villages in Dash state. First of all, remember this, it was a pilot program that was implemented by the Agriculture Ministry along with your whom? Microsoft. All right, along with Microsoft. And this was started in 6 states, and in 6 states there covered around 100 villages. All right, they covered around 100 villages in the 6 states. So the answer becomes Microsoft. Option 2 is correct. And Microsoft along with Agriculture Ministry started a pilot program that will help to increase the farmers' income. And it was started in 6 states. And in 6 states, they covered 100 villages under this program. The six states that we are talking about here are Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Haryana, Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh. All right, these are the six states. Next, which organization recently partnered with Niti Aayog for empowering Atal Tinkering Labs in school across India? The organization that partnered with Niti Aayog was AICTE. AICTE along with Niti Aayog for developing or for empowering the Atal Tinkering Labs in school across India. Next, who was honored with the Knight of the Orders of Arts and the Letters of France? See, this award by the name Knight of the Order of Arts and Letters of France. This was honored to a person for world cinema. In the field of world cinema, to whom? It was honored to Guneet Monga. Theek hai? Guneet Monga. Next question. Which country is planning to send a rover named Rashid to the moon? Rashid is a rover that will be sent to moon by UAE, and Rashid will be the rover that will be taken to the moon by the rockets of SpaceX. SpaceX is the company of Elon Musk. Another companies of Elon Musk are Tesla, SpaceX, Neuralink, Boring Company. All right, these all are the companies of Elon Musk. So correct option is United Arab Emirates. Next, in August 2021, Asian Games silver medal winner Balbir Singh Jr. passed away. From which post did he represent? Important question. See, Asian Games, silver medal holder by the name Balbir Singh Jr. He passed away. He was related to which sport? He was related to hockey. Alright, he was related to hockey. Question can be framed in any way. A silver medalist who used to play hockey recently passed away. What was the name? He was Balbir Singh Jr. This way can also be the question be framed. Alright, so next. Who authored the book Believe What Life and Cricket Taught Me? Important question. This book, Believe What Life and Cricket Taught Me, was authored by Suresh Raina. And it was co-authored by Bharat Sudarshan Ji. Alright, Bharat Sudarshan. He was a famous author recently because he also wrote the book, The Dhoni Touch. Alright, Dhoni Touch. So, Bharat Sudarshan Ji along with Suresh Raina authored the book, Believe What Life and Cricket Taught Me. Next question. Who authored the book, Being Gandhi? Being Gandhi was the book. Who authored this book, Being Gandhi? It was authored by Paro Anand. Alright, it was authored by Paro Anand. Next, which country will host the first United Nations Food Systems Summit, which will be held in September 2021? United Nations Food Systems Summit that will be held in September 2021 will be hosted by whom? It will be hosted by New York, USA. Alright, New York, USA. Which country partnered with the Observer Research Foundation to host the 6th Raisana Dialogue, India's global conference on the geopolitics and geoeconomics? I repeat, which is the ministry that partnered with the Observer Research Foundation to host the 6th Raisana Dialogue, India's global conference on geopolitics and geoeconomics? The ministry that we are talking about here is Ministry of External Affairs. Alright, there was a theme for this Raisana Dialogue. The theme is Viral World Outbreaks, Outliers and Out of Control. Outbreaks, Outliers and Out of Control. This was the theme for the 6th Raisana Dialogue. Alright, 6th Raisana Dialogue. If we are talking about Raisana, then do remember the Parliament of India is built on Raisana Hills. All right, it is built on Rizana Hills. All right, moving on to the next question. What is the rank of Indian passport as per the Henley Passport Index according in the second quarter of the global ranking? So as we know, the rank or the power of the passport is released by Henley Passport Index, and this for the second quarter of 2021, the rank of Indian passport as per the Henley Passport Index is, tell me, what is the rank? According to the Henley Passport Index, for the second quarter, the rank is 84th. Fifth option is correct, 84th. It is topped by Japan. On second, it is Singapore. And on third, it is South Korea. All right, next. India was ranked dash in the Inclusive Internet Index 2021 released by the Economist Intelligence Unit in partnership with Dash. What is the rank of India in the Inclusive Internet Index 2021? And who releases this Inclusive Internet Index 2021? It is released by EIU. EIU is your Economist Intelligence Unit, and this is in partnership with whom? It is in partnership with Facebook, and the rank of India is 49. All right, fifth option is correct. India was ranked 49 in the Inclusive Internet Index 2021, and this was released by Economist Intelligence Unit in partnership with Facebook. The countries that topped in it was Sweden, then it was your USA, and then it was Spain on third number. The rank of India in 2020 was 52. All right, next. Who won the 2021 Emilia Romagna Grand Prix? 2021's Emilia Romagna Grand Prix was won by Max Verstappen. Next. In April 2021, Charles Gascek, the developer of Dash, passed away. Charles Gascek was the developer of PDF. PDF stands for Portable Document Format. Alright, so option 4th is correct. Next. When is the UN's Chinese Language Day annually observed? UN's Chinese Language Day is observed annually on 20th of April. It is observed on 20th of April. Next. Which ministry launched the awareness event on the gender related intervention by the name Gender Samvad? Gender Samvad. This is a awareness event on the gender related intervention, and it was launched or it was started by which ministry? It was started by Ministry of Rural Development. All right. Next. Dash is the only state in India to have a uniform civil code, which is one of the directive principle of state policy under Dash. Directly it is asking under which article it comes, the uniform civil code. So remember, Goa is the only state in India to have a uniform civil code, and this comes under Article 44. Uniform civil code is basically that all the people, irrespective of religion, have to follow the same personal laws such as marriage and your child adoption. Alright, so this comes under Article 44, that is your Uniform Civil Code. If I ask you regarding the untouchability, article of untouchability, under which article untouchability comes, tell me. Untouchability comes under Article 17. First of all, 17, 18, 19. Let's revise all. Under Article 16 comes equal opportunities in jobs. Article 17 is for abolition of untouchability. Article 18 is regarding your titles, and Article 19 is your freedom of speech. All right, it is your freedom of speech. Next. Which organization released the State of World Population 2021 by the name report? Is report's name is My Body is My Own, Claiming the Right to Autonomy and Self-Determination Report. I repeat, the name of the report is My Body is My Own, Claiming the Right to Autonomy and Self-Determination. This report was recently released by whom? It was released by UNFPA, United Nations Fund for Population Activities. And this is a first of its kind report that was released by UN for the first time on body autonomy. All right, next. Which is the first country to ratify the RCEP? First country to ratify Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership was Singapore. If we are talking about RCEP, this was an initiative of China. India was also a part of RCEP till 2019, but in 2019, India exited RCEP. Next. Which company partnered with Federal Bank to launch a neo-banking app by the name Fee for the Salaried Millennials? The company that partnered with Federal Bank was Google Pay to launch a neo-banking app by the name Fee for the Salaried People. Alright, next. India secured dash rank in the World Press Freedom Index 2021, which is continuously topped for the fifth time by Dash. The rank of India in the World Press Freedom Index is 142. And this is the fifth time that Norway has topped in this index. I repeat, India ranked 142 in World Press Freedom Index in 2021. And Norway is the country that topped again for the fifth time in this index. Alright, so the option that is correct is option 3, 142 and Norway. Next, India was ranked Dash in the Fostering Effective Energy Transition 2021 report released by Dash. India was ranked 87th in the Fostering Effective Energy Transition 2021 report that was released by WEF, that is your World Economic Forum. Option 5 is correct. Next, in April 2021, First Rand Bank decided to withdraw all its banking services from India. It was South Africa. We have done this question. What is the GDP forecast of India for the fiscal year 2022 as per the CARE ratings? According to the CARE ratings, the GDP forecast of India for the year fiscal year 2022 as per the CARE ratings is 10.2%. Alright, it is 10.2%. Alright, 10.1% is given by whom? It is projected by Indian Ratings and Research. Alright, 10.1 is the GDP projected for the fiscal year 2022 by Indian Ratings and Research, 10.1. And if we are talking about CARE rating, for CARE rating, it is 10.2. For CARE rating, and if we are talking about Indian research, Indian rating and research, it is 10.1. Don't get confused in it. All right, then next. Who was the person that featured in the Forbes 30 under the 30 Asia 2021 list? The person that was featured in the Forbes 30 under the 30 Asia under 30 Asia list in 2021. Who was he? The name of the person was Vibha Harish. Alright, Vibha Harish was the person that featured in the Forbes 30 or the Forbes under 30 list in 2021. Alright, mark this important. Under 30 Asia list of Forbes 30. Alright, next. Who won the 2021 Nelson Mandela World Humanitarian Award? I repeat, 2021's Nelson Mandela World Humanitarian Award was received by, or the person that was honored with the National Nelson Mandela World Humanitarian Award was whom? It was Rumana Sinha Sehgal. Rumana Sinha Sehgal was the person that was honored with Nelson Mandela World Humanitarian Award. This is important. Next question. Who won the Golden Lion Award for the Lifetime Achievement at the 78th Venice International Film Festival? I repeat, Golden Lion Award for Lifetime Achievement at 78th वेनिस इंटरनेशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवल. हु रिसीव्ड दिस गोल्डन लाइन अवार्ड? इट वॉज रिसीव्ड बाय रोबर्टो बेंजिनी. ऑल राइट, इट वॉज रिसीव्ड बाय रोबर्टो बेंजिनी. नेक्स्ट, विच कंट्री इज प्लानिंग टू लैंड इट्स फर्स्ट मार्स रोवर जूरोंग ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ मार्स बाय मे 21? जूरोंग. जूरोंग इज अ rover that will be landed on the surface of Mars by the May 2021. The question is, which is the country that is planning, or which is the country the Zhurong belongs to? Zhurong belongs to which country? It belongs to China. All right, so Zhurong belongs to China, and it is a rover that will be landed on the surface of Mars this month, that is in May 2021. Next, who won the 2021 Barcelona Open? Barcelona Open is related to tennis. And who won this award, Barcelona Open 2021? This was won by Rafael Nadal. Rafael Nadal. And remember, this is the 68th edition of this award. 68th edition of 2021 Barcelona Open. Remember, Barcelona Open, if it is related to tennis, then you should also know that on which type of field it is played. It is played on clay court. Clay courts. Alright. Then next. Also remember, if I talk to you about Wimbledon, Wimbledon is played on grass. Australian Open is played on hard court. Alright. And also, US Open is also played on hard court. Next, Dash topped the medal tally at the AIBA Youth World Boxing Championship held in Dash. So, who topped the medal tally at the AIBA Youth World Boxing Championship? India topped the medal tally. Alright, and this was held in Kielce, Poland. It was held in Kielce, Poland. India topped this medal tally at AIBA Youth World Boxing Championship that was held in Poland. Next, who was appointed as the non-official director of the Central Board of RBI by Finance Ministry in April 2021? We have covered this question and the answer is Ajay Sheth. Who was appointed as the brand ambassador of the Japanese sports ASICS? ASICS is a Japanese sports brand, and Ravindra Jadeja has been appointed as the brand ambassador of ASICS. ASICS is a Japanese sports brand, and Ravindra Jadeja has been appointed as the brand ambassador of ASICS. Next question. Which organization developed the single crystal blades technology for helicopter engine application that can withstand high temperatures? I repeat, the organization that developed the single crystal blades technology for helicopters engine application that can withstand high temperature. It was developed by whom? It was developed by DRDO, that is your Defense Research and Development Organization. Next, in April 2021, OneWeb launched 36 LEO, that is your low earth orbiter communication satellites, from which country? OneWeb launched 36 low earth orbiter communication satellites from Russia. All right, option 5 is correct. Next, which country recently launched its spy satellite NROL-82? Remember, the question can be directly asked like, which is the country recently that launched a spy satellite? It was launched by USA. All right, and the name of the satellite is NROL-82. Next, in April, a famous writer and a Padma Shri awardee, Manzoor, passed away. He was famous writer in which language? I repeat, Manzoor Ehtisham was a Padma Shri awardee and a famous writer of which language? He was a famous writer of Hindi language. All right, Manzoor Ehtisham. Next question. Indian Navy participated in the bilateral naval exercise by the name Varuna with Dash. Varuna is a naval exercise that is conducted between India and France, and this was conducted in which region? It was conducted in the Arabian Sea. Alright, so option which is correct? Option B is correct, that is France and Arabian Sea. I told you Varuna is an exercise or a naval exercise that is conducted between India and France. नेक्स्ट, व्हाट इज द इंडियाज रैंक इन द चैंडलर गुड गवर्नमेंट इंडेक्स इन द फर्स्ट एडिशन प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द चैंडलर इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ गवर्नेंस CIG. इट इज अ फर्स्ट एडिशन ऑफ द such type of index, that is Chandler Good Government Index, that has been produced by Chandler Institute of Governance for the first time, and the rank of India is being asked here. The rank of India is 49. All right, 49. Next, which international organization provided a total of 1.5 billion or 1.11 lakh crore to India for tackling COVID-19. The organization that gave such a huge amount to India for tackling COVID-19 situation in India is ADB, Asian Development Bank. Next, which company partnered with NPCI, International Payments Limited, to expand its UPI transaction in the global market? And the name of the company is Financial Software and Systems. Financial Software and Systems. Which organization announced a financial assistance of rupees 135 crore to India for procuring medical supplies including oxygen to tackle COVID-19? I repeat, the organization that announced a financial assistance of 135 crore to India for procuring medical supplies that includes oxygen to tackle COVID-19 situation in India is Google. All right, Google. Next. Which organization projected India's GDP to grow by 11% in the fiscal year 2022 in its Asian Development Outlook in April 2021? I repeat, the company's name is first of all ADB, Asian Development Bank. Asian Development Bank projected India's GDP to grow by 11% in the fiscal year 2022 in its Asian Development Outlook. All right, next. Next question is important. Who became the first Asian woman to receive the Wild Innovator Award in 2021? The person that received, or the person who was honored with the Wild Innovator Award, or she became the first Asian woman. Who is the first Asian woman to receive the Wild Innovator Award? And the name of the person is Dr. Kirti K. Karnath. Dr. Kirti K. Karnath was the person. She became the first Asian woman. First Asian women to receive this Wild Innovator Award. Next, when is the World Day for Safety and Health at Work annually observed by the UN? I repeat, World Day for Safety and Health is annually observed on 28th of April by the UN. Next question is, which article of Indian Constitution provides the power to the President of India to appoint Prime Ministers and the Council of Ministers? So the article is 75 of Indian Constitution that provides the power to President of India to appoint PM and the Council of Ministers. So option 2, article 75 is correct. Next, where is the headquarters of the Center for Wildlife Studies? The Center for Wildlife Studies. Where is the headquarter of the Centers for Wildlife Studies? It is in Bangalore, Karnataka. Important. Headquarter of the Centers for Wildlife Studies is in Bangalore, Karnataka. Next, in April 2021, the Union Cabinet approved the signing of an agreement on customs cooperation and mutual administrative assistance in the custom matters between India and which country? It was between India and United Kingdom. Next. Where does the Border Roads Organization constructed road through its oldest project by the name Dantak? Dantak is an oldest project by which a BRO is constructing roads recently. BRO is your Border Roads Organization. So in which country, where does BRO is constructing road under this Dantak project? It is constructed in Bhutan. All right, Bhutan. Next. Which country announced a COVID-19 relief fund of rupees 18 crores to India in April 2021? So Norway provided a additional amount of 18 crores for India to tackle COVID-19 situation. Next, which bank launched the digital banking service Merchant Stack to serve its retail merchant customers? the bank that launched the digital banking service by the name Merchant Stack to serve its retail merchant customers is ICICI Bank. ICICI Bank. Next, which are the two Indian companies that were listed among the Time magazine's first ever list? That is the name Time 100 Most Influential Companies. I repeat, the two companies that were listed in the Time 100 Most Influential Companies for the first time were Jio Platform and Byju's. Alright, were Jio Platform and Byju's. Also remember that Time 100 Most Influential Companies, this is the first ever list of Time magazine. Alright, next. Dash successfully conducted the maiden trial of the short-range air-to-air missile Python 5. Python 5 is a short-range air-to-air missile, and the Dash, which company conducted the successful trial of this short-range air-to-air missile Python 5? Remember, DRDO conducted the successful trials of this Python short-range air-to-air missile, and this was conducted where? At Goa. Alright, it was conducted at Goa. Next, with which supercomputer manufacturer did the UK's Met Office sign an agreement to develop the world's fastest supercomputer by 2022? UK's Met Office has signed with Microsoft to develop the world's fastest supercomputer by 2022. So remember, UK's Met Office along with the Microsoft will be developing the fastest computer by 2022, fastest supercomputer. Next, who won individual recurve gold medals in the archery World Cup stage 1 in April 2020? Alright, who won the recurve gold medals in the archery World Cup stage? There were two persons, you have to remember. Atanu Das and Deepika Kumari. I repeat, Atanu Das and Deepika Kumari, they were the two persons to win the individual gold medals in the archery World Cup stage 1. So option 4th is correct, both 1 and 2. Next, who edited the book Interpreting Politics, Situated Knowledge, India and the Rudolf Legacy? I repeat the name of the book, Interpreting Politics, Situated Knowledge, India and the Rudolf Legacy. This book was also edited by two persons by the name John Ankiver Gent and Susan Rudolph. John Ankiver Gent and Susan Rudolph. So option 4th is correct. Both 1 and 2. Alright, next. Which organization annually observes the Play True Day in April 2021? I repeat, the organization that annually observes the Play True Day in April is World Anti-Doping Agency. World Anti-Doping Agency annually observes Play True Day. Next, and the last question of the video is, who is the present chairman and the managing director of BSNL? The present chairman and the managing director of BSNL is Praveen Kumar Purwar. Praveen Kumar Purwar. So friends, this was our video. I hope you enjoyed our video. If you liked our video, do hit the like button, share the link with your friends. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel or if you are new to our channel, then do subscribe because it motivates us to bring a better content for you guys. Also, if you have any trouble regarding login or payment or any other issues, then you can reach to us on our mail, that is support@affairscloud.com, or you can call us on the number 9677333862 and we'll resolve your issue as soon as possible. Also, you should go and check our courses that are available at a very reasonable price, and that will help you to boost your preparations for upcoming government exams. You can use the code VIKAS10 to get a straight 10% discount on any purchase you make. Alright, so that's all for the day. Take care.